Hey, so today's video is gonna be a little bit different than the previous ones because completely doing a different process. When we were looking at doing the base, I wanted to make sure I had it pretty good. And there's a lot of circles and straight lines. And then of course there's the hexagons. So I wanna get it right. So I decided that I wanna get it CNC cut and we kind of make like a, almost like a stencil to get everything together and put together as a big puzzle piece. So to do that, I hooked up with a friend of mine, John Anderson, who you've probably seen in one of the interview videos, which I'll link up in the cards here so you can take a look. And I'm gonna show you some of the process. So what we did is we took it all and made a 3D model of the base and then spliced it up so that we're actually going to CNC machine. So I'll show you a little bit of that. CNC is actually really interesting. In the office I'm in here there's this sign right here, is Oxenham Design. He does amazing work, and I'm talking like amazing 3D work, and does a lot with CNC, and you can do some really amazing things. So that's what we're gonna do here. So here we go, and I'll, as the process goes on, you'll see some of that, and we'll see some of more explanation, a little bit more technical than what I'm giving you right now. And there we go. So here we go. All right, so what you're seeing here is actually the CNC plotter path. It's a bit sped up, but you can get an idea about how the plotter planned to cut all my shapes out of the first sheet. And it gives us a kind of a neat thing to kind of plot out and see how it works. Now this is me here screwing in the screws. You actually have to bolt in the panel so that it doesn't shift around while it's cutting, especially complex shapes. Apparently, typically for thinner things or smaller things, you can actually get away with double-sided tape, but we had to screw them down. So there's me doing that, fixing a little bit of problem there that I did initially, and getting ready to go. So here is the CNC plotter. It is going at, well, this is a 2000, I sped up 2000% just to get an idea. Otherwise it would be a very, very long video. But you can get an idea how it's actually moving along, cutting out all the shapes. It was really actually kind of neat to watch. It took probably about, I think about 27 minutes or so to do this first sheet, mostly because of all the complex little parts. The second sheet took a little bit less. But as you can see, it's going through, cutting my hexagons, my circles, plotting out everything. And as you see, you know, quickly speeding in and out, it was Jamie, the owner of Oxenham Designs, who was making sure it was all clear and clean, who I can't thank enough for actually for letting me use the space to do this and to film. It was kind of neat. Most of the time you wouldn't be able to see all this kind of information. So thank you so much to Jamie for doing that. And be sure to check the link in the description for his information. All right, so the cool thing so far is that we've got one sheet done, so we're just loading up the other sheet here. But you can probably see right here, nice tall view, these are our pieces so far. So we have a lot of things to go through. It's gonna be one big puzzle. So it's time for sheet number two, which is gonna actually have some of the side panels as well. So anyway, pretty excited, and time for sheet two. Yeah, so here we go, it's another angle, but it's the second sheet. It's pretty cool. What you're seeing here being cut out is actually the ends of each of the main panels, each of the top panels. I figured we'd do them CNC. We had the space, thanks to John, who figured out how we could get them in here. And then saved us a lot of time of actually figuring this part out. And they're gonna be all equal, so it's pretty cool. That was Jay there, eyeing the CNC machine. So yeah, so here we go. We're getting some of the more other shapes. Now this is, I think, mostly the small rings that go on the middle or the top rung of the circles, which you'll see in a minute as we build it all together. But here we go, the circles. Yeah, it was actually, like, this saves so much time. The angles were gonna be more precise, as well as just being, saving, like I said, saved a lot of time, yes, but it also saved a lot of time trying to figure out how to do the circles and what angles to cut at and make sure everything fit properly. It saved a ton of time. Playing a part was probably the most rewarding part here. And here we are cleaning everything up, making a lot of mess, but again, so, so worth it. All right, so we got all the sheets done, which I'll show in a little bit here, and we're gonna, you know, take those back, put them together. But yeah, it was a lot of fun to be here. Well worth the time to do CNC. So if you've never looked at CNC or thought about CNC, check it out. You should definitely check it out. And I'm gonna have a little bit here right here from John, who I did mention, as I mentioned earlier in the video, but he was also one of the people I interviewed at the prop party, and he helped me do some great 3D work. So check that out here.
I started following Justin's TARDIS build, mainly because he's a friend, but also because it's a really cool project. And as he was building, I noticed a couple things that maybe I could help with. Mainly CNC cutting some of the parts to get the base built. So I took some of his files and then reoriented some of the parts and helped configure a bit of the part structure so that it would be easy to build and reduce weight and be very strong. Justin had started, he had some of the parts, most of the parts drawn in Illustrator. So what I did was import a lot of those into Rhino, a 3D program that I enjoy working with. And I extruded a lot of them into the thickness to give a better sense of how the parts will come together and help eliminate some of these frustrations that come with building, going from a 2D world into a 3D world. And we were able to kind of sort out a better way to assemble the base as well as make sure everything was going to work together and have clearance for things, allow for some electronics and stuff like that.
Hey, so we're back at Jay's shop now and we're going to start assembling all these pieces that we got. So as you can see right here, we're going to start just bringing the base, this little test form of the bottom of the base, and then this part here. So we're going to start putting these little rings around and then we're going to have to build some pieces. We're going to do a little bit of testing to see how high it's going to be. But yeah, so here we go. We're gonna get this going and we'll show some progress as we go.
This is Justin working hard. Look at him go.
So here we are, the end of the day. Sorry I didn't take a lot more progress while we were going. I can show a couple pictures here so you can see what we did. And no, it went really well. I'm really excited. This is where we're at. Just gonna turn here. We have freaking console. Let me just flip this around here. Look at that. We have a console base. Pretty sweet. So we have things we need. So I am incredibly excited. I'm so happy to have this far done and it's gonna be really awesome to get everything else done. So we pretty much only have one, maybe 2 days left of actually building, and then it's gonna be the painting and everything and eventually installing things. So and then when we get to the actual top part to do, you know, the acrylic tubes on top. I also had to get acrylic tubes to go through here. And yeah, so having the CNC machine actually made a big difference. I'm really happy that I went ahead and did that. Special thanks to John Anderson for helping me with that. And of course, Jay for doing this for me here. It's been awesome. If you have any questions, just ask me in the comments below. I'll try and answer them as best as I can. Like I said, these pictures I'm showing here should at least give an example of what we actually did and how it goes from there. And hopefully the 3D model from John could also explain a lot. But again, ask me any questions in the comments below. Be sure to click over, make sure I can see myself here. Click over here and subscribe. I'm gonna have more of these videos and we're almost getting to the point where it's gonna be the nitty gritty and then back to the panel dissection videos just so you can, you know, see how those all work out. But anyway, be sure to like and subscribe. But most of all, thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching.